Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Commissioner, you're an attorney. Can you explain for our fellow citizens what the phrase spoliation of evidence means?
I have no idea what that means.
Well, I'm going to help you with it, okay? Spoliation of evidence is when a party fails to preserve evidence, there's a negative inference that the jury can draw from their failure to preserve the evidence. You with me? If you destroy documents, the jury can infer that those documents weren't going to be good for you. If you fail to keep documents, the jury can infer that those documents were not going to be good for you. You've heard the phrase spoliation of evidence, haven't you?
I can't recall ever hearing.
It's true in administrative hearings, civil hearings, criminal hearings.
I practiced law once 45 years ago, gave it up for Lent 1 year, never went back.
All right. Well, let me tell you what you would have found if you had stuck with it. When a party has a duty to preserve evidence or records and they fail to do so, there is a negative inference that is drawn from their failure to preserve the evidence. It's common sense, right? If you destroyed something, the jury has a right to infer that whatever you destroyed would not have been good for you, or else every litigant would destroy whatever evidence was detrimental to them. Agreed?
I'm not sure. I think if you destroy the evidence and people could prove it, it wouldn't be a good thing for your defense.
Well, no, it's worse than that. The jury can draw, and they're instructed, they can draw a negative inference.
All right.
And that's true if a taxpayer is being sued by the IRS administratively, civilly, or prosecuted criminally, and they fail to keep documents, the jury can draw a negative inference from the fact that they didn't keep receipts or emails or documents. So if it's true and it applies to a taxpayer, it ought to apply to the IRS as well. Agreed?
Is this a trial? Is this a jury? Is that what you're...
I said administrative, civil, or criminal. If you want to go down that road, I'm happy to go down it with you, Commissioner. In fact, I'm glad you mentioned it. You have already said multiple times today that there was no evidence that you found of any criminal wrongdoing. I want you to tell me what criminal statutes you've evaluated.
I have not looked at any.
Well, then how can you possibly tell our fellow citizens that there's no criminal wrongdoing if you don't even know what statutes to look at?
Because I've seen no evidence that anyone consciously...
Well, how would you know what elements of the crime existed? You don't even know what statutes are at play. I'm going to ask you again.
I think...
What statutes have you evaluated?
I think you can rely on common sense that nothing I have seen...
Common sense. Instead of the criminal code, you want to rely on common sense. No, Mr. Cox, you can shake your head all you want to, Commissioner. You have said today that there's no evidence of criminal wrongdoing. And I'm asking you what criminal statutes you have reviewed to reach that conclusion.
I have reviewed no criminal statute.
All right. So you don't have any idea whether there's any criminal conduct or not because you don't know the elements of the offense.
I have seen no evidence of wrongdoing.
Oh, well, that's very different from no evidence of criminal misconduct, Commissioner.
Well, it seems to me if you haven't done wrongdoing, it'd be pretty hard to argue that you've had some criminal violation if you didn't.
Well, what did
wrong.
Lois Lerner mean when she said perhaps the FEC will save the day?
I have no idea what.
What did she say? What did she mean when she said we need a project, but we need to be careful that it doesn't appear to be per se political? You don't think that's a potential violation of 18-242?
I have no idea if it...
Because you haven't looked at 18-242, and you don't have any idea, Commissioner. You don't have any idea whether there's any criminal wrongdoing or not.
With regard to the production of the evidence, the production of Lois Lerner emails, I have seen no evidence of wrongdoing. What else
well,
went on?
Well,
what
if
else
there
went
were,
on,
that would be a separate criminal
what else,
offense.
What else went on with Lois Lerner, I've said in the past...
So what you're saying is you don't have any idea whether she engaged in criminal wrongdoing. You're just saying that you did not engage in any with respect to the emails.
I haven't seen any wrongdoing with regard to the production of Lois Lerner emails.
But you are not saying there was no criminal wrongdoing with respect to the targeting of conservative groups. I want to be very clear. You're not saying that.
I've made no judgments.
So you disagree with the president when he says there's not a smidgen of corruption.
There are people who have been making judgments both sides about whether there were...
And you know what? I'm not one of those. I'm just simply saying we will never know because you didn't keep the evidence.
Uh-huh.
The evidence was spoliated. And whether it's negligent, whether it's intentional, whether it's reckless, we still don't have the evidence, Commissioner.
Well, you have the evidence that there is no emails from the White House. You have all of the Treasury emails. So the basic premise... that this was an argument in a conspiracy driven by the White House does not...
No, sir, you're wrong about that. You're wrong about that. That you're repeating a talking point from our colleagues on the other side that we're obsessed with the White House. It was Jay Carney who perpetuated the myth that it was two rogue agents in Ohio. It wasn't any of us. Was that accurate? Was that first initial line of defense, that this is just two rogue agents in Ohio? Was that accurate, Commissioner?
Not that I know of.
All right, so that wasn't accurate, and that came from the White House. Who said there's not a smidgen of corruption? Who said that, Commissioner?
My understanding is that was the president.
All right, it was the president. So that's Jay Carney and the president both inserting themselves into the IRS scandal. And you want to blame us for bringing the White House into it?
I haven't blamed you at all.
You just did, Commissioner. You just did.
Well, it's a good argument. All I said was the White House has revealed there were no Lois Lerner emails. Treasury has given you all of their emails. So to the extent that the argument was that Lois Lerner was conspiring and emailing back and forth, thus far, I haven't seen any.
Well, you can be engaged in a conspiracy that doesn't include the White House.
Gentlemen.
Good. I think time's up. Right. Thank you, sir.
Well, I was wanting to let him go, but the guy beside me kept grabbing me.